So hello everyone, in today's session we will move ahead with the bivariate regression technique. Okay, so what do we mean by that? So in this case we will comprehend the nature of correlation analysis, we will understand what is bivariate regression analysis, and to become aware of the coefficient of determination, that is R square. Okay, so what is bivariate regression analysis? What is the meaning of bivariate? Meaning of bivariate is that it is involving two variables. Okay, it will involve two variables, that is called bivariate. What is multivariate? If it involves more than two variables, that is multivariate regression analysis. Okay, so in this case let's start with what is regression analysis. Okay, so we want to measure basically if there is any linear association between a dependent variable and independent variable. I'll come to the definition of what is a dependent variable and independent variable. So just in the simple definition is basically the regression analysis is a technique which will help you to measure the linear association between a dependent and independent variable. Okay, so regression is called as dependence technique, right? And where correlation is called as interdependence technique. So what is interdependence? So in interdependence technique, it does not make any distinction between does not make the distinction one is independent or dependent. It is related, interrelated, right? So we had seen that example of that duration of stay in the city and attitude towards the city, right? Those are related, correlated, right? Now in dependence technique, since regression is a dependence technique, it makes a distinction between dependent and independent variables. Okay, so what is a dependent variable or independent variable? For a simple regression, a dependent variable is nothing but the variable which is to be predicted or the outcome variable. Okay, and the independent variables are those variables which are predictor variable, the variables which is available to you on the basis of which you are going to predict something. For example, if you take an example of predicting sales, you are working for an organization and you want to predict sales. Okay, sales of a product. Say if I want to predict sales of iPhone 8, what are the factors do you think can affect the sales of iPhone 8? That can affect or that can influence the sale of iPhone 8? What do you think? Price, performance, okay. What else? Cost, style, okay. Okay. Also, can I say, will that affect? Right? Advertisement. Right, advertisement can affect. So if any one of you are using, I think that not sure, they are advertising very heavily on Sony Live app, right? So basically the ads could be of many type. Your ad could be online, right? Your ad could be over TV, your ad could be over radio, okay, your ad could be over social media and whatnot, right? Now if you are going to predict sales and let's say it is dependent on advertisement, so in this case sales is your dependent variable. Okay, sales is your dependent variable while advertisement is your independent variable. Okay, if I am going to predict, let's say, a customer's income, okay, if I am going to predict customers or maybe a person's income, via basically the house that customer, that person owns, what is the age, okay, number of cars that person can have, right? So in this case, what will be your dependent variable and independent variable? So what will be your dependent variable in this case? Income. Income is your dependent variable. What is your independent variable? House, age, car. Okay, so this is an example of multivariate. Multivariate, right? While the earlier sales and advertisement example was bivariate. Okay, right. So this is what is all about. Okay, so let's move on and see what are the bivariate analysis techniques. Okay, so bivariate analysis is defined when there is a degree of association between two variables, right? So we will use bivariate techniques for analyzing. There are different statistical methods which is used to analyze the relationship between two variables. So if you know the relationship between two variables, okay, how that will be useful? Will that be useful if you know the relationship between two variables? Will it be useful if you know the relationship between two variables? How? So if I know sales is 1.5 times of TV ad cost, right? So whatever you are going to invest in advertisement, that you can expect in terms of sales. So if you invest $1 in sales, you are going to get $1.5, right? So that will help you to predict what is going to be the scenario. Now we have talked about correlation. Do you remember what was correlation? What was the measure of correlation coefficient? Okay, measure of correlation coefficient was small r, right? And small r lies between minus 1 to plus 1. Closer it, this r is to 1, the absolute value of r, the closer it to 1, the stronger the relation, isn't it? So can I say that is also a bivariate technique? Yes. So there are, in correlation there are two variables, so that is also a bivariate technique. Okay, so when there is a multivariate technique, when more than two variables are involved, so that becomes, if it is greater than two variables, that becomes multivariate. What is independent variable? Independent variables which is used to affect the value of dependent variable. Those value are independent in their values. Okay, they don't depend on any of the other variables to get its value, while the dependent variable is explained or caused by the independent variable. Okay, so that's pretty simple. Now let's move on and look at, so bivariate analysis of association. So there are different type of bivariate procedures. You have two group t-test, chi-square test, analysis of variance, which is ANOVA, bivariate regression, and Pearson product moment correlation, right? This we have studied, this correlation. Okay, Now let's see, let's move it a little further. So bivariate regression, what is bivariate regression? Bivariate regression is between two variables, so it is going to give you the strength of linear relationship, okay, between dependent variable and independent variable. Okay, remember this regression when we are talking about the linear relationship. So what is the formula of linear relationship? What is the equation of line? Y equal to mx plus c. Equation of line, that could be x equal to y, but in general terms it will be y equal to mx plus c. What is m here? M is your gradient or slope. Gradient or slope. Right? X is your, what is X here? What is X here? Is this dependent variable or independent variable? This is independent variable. And Y is dependent variable. What is C here? Constant or intercept. Okay, so if you draw a line, basically this is going to be your C here, this is your Y, it is X, and what is M here? M will be your this slope, right? So this line is given by the equation Y equal to mx plus c. So bivariate regression is also a linear relationship. Now, how do you get to know the nature of relationship? So you plot that into scatter diagram. So in correlation, we had plotted the scatter diagram, if you're familiar. So what is a scatter plot? It is a plot between, we talked about age and income. It's a plot between two variables. Yeah, so in this case, the bivariate regression, the nature of relationship, you plot the scatter diagram. The dependent variable is plotted on the y-axis, that is vertical axis. This is called vertical axis and this is horizontal. So independent variable is plotted against horizontal or x-axis. Okay, so scatter plot can tell you a linear relationship or non-linear relationship. Okay, now let's understand how do you conduct bivariate regression analysis. Okay, first and foremost, first step is to plot the scatter diagram to understand what is the relationship. Okay, then you formulate the general model. What the general model is going to be, you formulate it, right? I will come to each of the steps one by one. Then next step is to estimate the parameters. What are the parameters? I will explain them. Then next step is to estimate the standardized regression coefficients. Then next is testing the significance. So here we will use hypothesis testing to test the significance. Next is determining the strength and significance of this association. So what, how strong this association is, you need to determine, and then you check the prediction accuracy. Finally, examine the residuals and cross validate the model, and then understand the statistics associated with bivariate regression analysis.
I'm sure you enjoyed learning from this video. Please like the video, and if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment us in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more information, visit our website now. Keep learning with Intellipaat.